ocean in summers? It's so cold over there. And the summers of Delhi, oh, it's so hot. One more thing, have you ever enjoyed cold strawberry ice cream? Yummy yum. And yes, that sizzling hot chocolate brownie. Nothing can beat it. You would be thinking, what teacher is saying today? Yes, I am here to welcome you all. Shubha welcome you on Fun to Science. And we are going to begin our journey now. Have you taken the ticket? No? Why? Take the ticket. Hit that subscribe button. And let's begin our journey. I was talking about hotness and coldness. What is this hotness and coldness? This is something which we come across in our life. If mother is going to give us a glass of water, then also we judge whether this that water is cold or hot. Isn't it? So, cold and hot, coldness and hotness, it is something which we come across in our day-to-day life. What is this coldness and hotness? So, we measure that coldness and hotness. The measure of coldness and hotness is called as temperature. And that is our today's topic of discussion. Let us begin with the journey of this measurement quantity, temperature. Whenever we see, we touch something, then we can easily understand whether that is a cold or a hot. A Swedish scientist, Andrés Celsius, he was the first person to devise thermometer, which we use nowadays also. He was the first person who devised thermometer and found out the measurement method for temperature. He took the upper or highest point as the pure boiling point of water, and that he devised as 100. He cooled down the water to its maximum limit at 0 degree centigrade when it becomes ice. When pure water becomes ice, that he devised as 0 degree centigrade. Then he divided this 0 to 100 in 100 equal parts. That is why the word came in existence, that is centigrade. Centigrade stands for 100 equal gradations from 0 to 100, that is from ice, the temperature of ice, to boiling point of pure water. And this is how the first scale to measure the temperature has been devised. Now we also use this scale as degree Celsius scale. In honor of the scientist Andrés Celsius, we call it degree Celsius. It is centigrade scale. After finding out this centigrade scale, we came to know the body temperature of a human body is 37 degrees centigrade. Then we defined that anything which is above 37 degrees centigrade is considered as hot. Anything which is below 37 degrees centigrade is considered as cold. And from here, we came to know that hotness or coldness is a relative term. Our body is having sensory system, and temperature of our body is 37 degrees centigrade. When we touch anything, it measures whether that the temperature of the object we are touching is more than 37 centigrade or less than 37 degrees centigrade. If we feel it hot, that
That means the temperature of an object which we are touching is more than 37 degrees centigrade. When the temperature of an object we are touching is less than 37 degrees centigrade, we feel it as a cold. So, temperature is relative term. We use this Andrew Celsius scale as a centigrade scale for our day-to-day life. Then SI unit came in existence and it was necessary to define the standard system which is accepted all over the world. So, a new scale came in existence. So, how this new scale has been designed? This was Andrew Celsius scale. It started from 0 degrees centigrade and divided into equal parts till 100 degrees centigrade. It is divided into equal part. Now degree by degree, we took this length as a standard length for a degree, and degree by degree we start reducing the temperature of objects, different metals, different elements which we know, and we came to know that there is one point which is -273 degree centigrade, below which we cannot cool down any element found on earth. So SI system defined -273 degree centigrade as their standard temperature below which nothing can be cooled down, no element found on earth can be cooled down, or energy cannot be taken out from any object or from any element which is found on earth. So it is called as absolute zero temperature. And SI unit system defined this absolute zero temperature as 0 degree Kelvin. Here one thing you have to note down, that this standard grade which Celsius has done is also considered as a standard gradation for Kelvin system of temperature, that is SI unit of temperature. Here I mean one unit of degree Celsius is equal to one unit of degree Kelvin. So SI system of unit defined a new scale which is called as Kelvin scale. Here in Kelvin scale, -273 degree centigrade is considered as 0 degree Kelvin. That means when you will come at 0 degree centigrade, it will be 273 degree Kelvin and the boiling point of water will be 373 degrees centigrade. If you want to convert this unit from degree Celsius to Kelvin, then you just have to add 273 to degree centigrade and you will get the temperature in Kelvin. Here I mean to say one or unit Kelvin is equal to degree centigrade plus 273. For example, if I want to convert our body temperature 37 degree centigrade to the Kelvin unit, we have to add 273 to it and we will get a degree Kelvin unit. Apart from these two scales, that is the degree Celsius scale and degree Kelvin scale, we have one more scale which is used in many European countries as well as in USA, and that is called as degree Fahrenheit. A German scientist, G.D. Fahrenheit, designed this scale. This scale is degree Fahrenheit scale. In this scale, the 0 degree, that is the freezing point of water, pure water, that is ice, is 32 degree Fahrenheit, while the boiling point of pure water is 212 degree Fahrenheit. He also graded this scale in which 5 units of degree centigrade is equal to 9 units of degree Fahrenheit. That means 5 units or 5 gradations which is on degree centigrade scale is equivalent to the 9 gradations of Fahrenheit scale. Like this, suppose degree centigrade is having 5 equal gradations, then on Fahrenheit scale, this is equivalent to 9 equal gradations. It is like this. So, 5 equal gradations of Celsius is equivalent to 9 equal gradations of Fahrenheit. That means, as in Kelvin scale, each gradation is equivalent to Kelvin gradation. That means 1 unit of centigrade is equal to 1 unit of Kelvin. But here it is not the case. The case is 5 unit of centigrade is 9 units of Fahrenheit. So if I want to convert these units, how do we go about it? So we can write like 5 centigrade, temperature in centigrade upon 5 is equal to Fahrenheit, temperature in Fahrenheit minus 32 upon 9. Minus 32 because 32 is a temperature which is equivalent to 0 degree centigrade. So 32 degree Fahrenheit is equal to 0 degree centigrade. If I want to convert centigrade to Fahrenheit or Fahrenheit to centigrade, we substitute the given temperature in centigrade or Fahrenheit in this formula and we can easily convert it. For example, if our body temperature is 37 degrees centigrade, then in Fahrenheit or degree Fahrenheit, what is it? We have to substitute it. We have given temperature in degree centigrade. So, we will substitute at the place of centigrade. That is 37 upon 5 is equal to Fahrenheit minus 32 upon 9. After this, we have to go for left hand side and right hand side adjustments. We are going to divide this, we are going to get 7.4. Then this 9 we are going to substitute to, this 9 we are going to shift to right left hand side. So we get this equation. Then we will shift this 32 to this side. So Fahrenheit we are going to calculate, and this is the value in degree Fahrenheit for our body temperature. Likewise, you can calculate many more. Like, first convert 25 degree centigrade to Fahrenheit. Convert 28 degree centigrade to degree Fahrenheit. Similarly, the last question, convert 115 degree Fahrenheit to degree centigrade, and write your answers in comment box. I hope you will definitely understand the calculation, simple substitution, and then left hand side, right hand side adjustments. Calculate the answer and write in comment box. Let us talk something about thermometer. Thermometer is mostly made up of glass and it has markings over it. You have seen thermometers at your home also. That is clinical thermometer. and the clinical thermometer has mostly Fahrenheit scale, which starts from 37 degree Fahrenheit to around 110 degree Fahrenheit. It depends on company to company. You just go and check the markings on your thermometer. You have seen the thermometer is triangular in shape. Okay, it is elongated, but it is not round. It is not cylindrical. It is triangular. Why it is triangular? Because there is a gradations or markings inside the thermometer. And this triangular shape, it magnifies that marking so that you can read the correct reading while taking the temperature. Similarly, I would like to mention in clinical thermometer, which you also have at home and which you see with doctors, they have a constriction at the end of the thermometer. This is a clinical thermometer. Here it is filled with mercury, and here when their reading is going to start, you have a constriction, that means a notch kind of thing, after which you have a straight capillary. Now why this notch? Because when you put the thermometer in your mouth and after some time you take it out, this mercury, it fills up the capillary as per your body temperature or according to your body temperature. While taking out and you take the reading, during this period this mercury should not fall back. So to avoid this falling back of mercury from capillary to this bulb, we have created one notch which avoid the fall of mercury. So these are two special things which you will see in clinical thermometer. Third point, in clinical thermometer we use mercury. Why we use mercury? Because mercury has a bigger range of temperature for boiling point and freezing point. It is very sensitive to temperature, that means very good conductor of heat. So a small raise in temperature can be noted down very easily. Third thing with mercury is it do not wet the glass. Capillary is made up of glass. So when it raises, it do not stick to the capillary of the glass. So it is not going to wet it. That is why the mercury is used most of the times in clinical thermometer. Similarly, we have one more type, that is laboratory thermometer. In laboratory thermometer, we use alcohol, and alcohol is also a very good conductor of heat. It expands with the raise in temperature and it contracts when there is a fall in temperature. So it is giving a very good response with the change in temperature, and that is why in laboratory we use alcohol based thermometers. As you know, the mercury, alcohol, they are toxic substances. So nowadays we have come up with a digital thermometer. Okay, and in our home now we are using digital thermometer, where at the notch here at the bulb we have very sensitive metal which immediately notes down the raise in temperature and gives us a very accurate reading in the form of digital numbers. So we don't have a trouble to note down the temperature. I hope you understood about the temperature, how it is devised, how we measure the temperature, and different kind of thermometers, along with the history. And definitely the SI unit, in honor of the scientist Kelvin, we have kept it as a degree Kelvin. So three scales of measuring temperature: degree Kelvin, degree centigrade and degree Fahrenheit. I think it will be paka paka with you, and you will definitely solve the problems. And send me your answers in comment box. Don't avoid it. And yes, subscribe my channel and like the video. See you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.